So, oh, I think I'm breaking a lot of hearts. Damn. Oh, what's up, you guys? Hi, welcome back to my channel. This is gonna be so interesting because I think this topic is really close to my heart. So, if you're watching this video, I want you to answer these questions first and then I'll take it forward, all right? If you're confused about where you stand in his life, if you're constantly crying in the washroom and at night before you sleep, if you are stalking him on social media because he hasn't replied to your text, or if he's not talking to you as much as he used to before, trust me, number one, you are down bad and you are screwed. I'm sorry. And number two, you are in the right place because I'm gonna help you out to understand where you actually stand in his life and what is the situationship that you are in right now. All right, we're gonna be talking about casual relationship and an actual relationship. All right, so yeah, welcome back to another Sunday video. We're doing dating tips, and this time it's gonna get really candid, and I'm gonna dive deeper into each of these subjects, help you guys understand better so that you do not end up in a heartbreak. All right, because I got you. All right, so without wasting any more time, let's get started. Okay, so today we are actually discussing the pros and cons of dating in this virtual world. We're all stuck, we're not meeting people. Everything's happening virtually, everything's happening digitally. You're either Skype calling a person, you're either texting a person, but there's no like physical contact happening for you to like really stick together for long to understand if you're compatible enough. People are not really patient enough to like, you know, give their time to one person. They're so distracted with like a lot of people around them because of dating apps or because of whatever, you know, like there is always an option available to every person. It's very easy in today's world to like really just ghost somebody if you think that, you know, the first date did not go well. So it's fine, you know what, I'm not gonna waste my time. I'm gonna talk to the other girl, I'm gonna talk to the other guy or something like that. But what happens is that sometimes you click, and you click in a way that you guys are fun together. Like there's a lot of things that you want to talk about, and there's like a lot of things that you share. But there is not enough compatibility, okay? And this is a real thing, all right? For example, I'm gonna put it in a story format so that you can understand better what I'm trying to say here. If you meet a guy, okay, you guys click, there's a lot of things in common between y'all, and then, you know, he even matches your zodiac compatibility and everything, and then you think that you found the right guy. Probably in his head, he does not think of you as the perfect girl that he's looking for, which is completely all right because everybody has their own check boxes to tick, right? But he thinks that you guys are fun together. Now, for guys, it's very easy to compartmentalize their thoughts and be like, okay, fine, you know what, she's fun, so I'm just gonna like be around with her for like a casual thing and just like, you know, keep it really, you know, like a hookup sort of a thingy, and just, you know, we'll be chill and then we'll see where it goes. This is how they vibe, okay? And for us, if we like a person, if we are even giving them 10 minutes of our time in a day, that means that we like them, okay? And because we do not generally do that with any other person, right? Like unless we are extremely bored and, you know, we want to talk to somebody and then we'll start talking to people. You get the vibe what I'm trying to say, right? When you start talking, initially you might be confused about this guy, but as you get to know him, you start liking him, and there might be a certain number of flaws in that person, but you're still like, okay, you know what, I have these many pros about this person and I have these many cons, which might be more than the pros, but I'm still ready to compromise because I like this person, because we vibe. But you have not really understood the compatibility part of it, or you don't even know if that person likes you back or not. You know, you've only accepted the fact that you like him basis the fantasy that you've created about this person in your head already. So the minute you start fantasizing, or the minute you start thinking about the guy in a certain manner, or if you start, you know, stalking him, or if you start talking about him to your friends, trust me, number one, you like him, you started liking him. So be ready either for a heartbreak or to get into a relationship, okay? Either or. Most of the times it ends up in a heartbreak until you finally find the right one. Now, how do you differentiate and understand if this thing, what you're feeling right now, if this is gonna end into a relationship or if this is just a casual thing, okay? There are ways to differentiate. What happens is, for us, because our brain is constantly working and we are like wired in a very complicated manner, our brain does not process simple things, okay? We have to make things complicated for ourselves only sometimes, right? But what happens is, guys want casual stuff, okay? And they are being sweet to you. They're being nice to you. So you feel like, okay, but he said, he likes me. Okay, but he said he wants to go out with me. The situation could be different, but the bottom line of the entire story, the crux of it, is that he may not be looking at you as a serious relationship. I'm really sorry to say this. Trust me, I've been on the same boat, bro. Like, I'm not trying to, like, whatever, make you feel bad, but I'm trying to explain you via my own experiences. So men don't mean to hurt you. They don't wish to hurt you. They want to be nice to you, okay? So when they're talking to you, they want to be nice to you, is what I feel, is what I've gathered from my experiences. They want to be nice to you, and they also want to have that little bit of bonding and that vibe, so that when they hook up, or like when you guys are casual together, it's fun, it's nice, okay? Unfortunately, that's the case. Oh, I think I'm breaking a lot of hearts by this video, but I don't know what to say, dude. And today I'm not even in the mood to like do any skincare routine or anything. I just want to sit and talk about this because I feel it's important to understand and to separate your thoughts sometimes. Now, as I said, the guy could say a number of things. They could say everything. They could literally say, I love you. They could literally say, you are the woman for me. They have to follow up those words with some action so that you can believe and trust him that, yes, this is the guy and this is, what it is. Okay, I'll tell you the entire process and the entire cycle. What happens generally is that when women, as I said, when you start liking a guy, you will start creating stories and, you will start becoming, you'll get those Ali moments in your head, as I said. Once you start getting Ali moments, you've already pictured him a part of your life. Okay, like this guy is a part of your life now. So you want him to message you every day. You want him to like be there with you constantly, or you want him to be a part of your day-to-day routine, right? Some or the other way. But then this guy is not as invested in you as you are already. In fact, you might not even know much about this guy, okay? You're just creating this persona of this person in your head, and you're just enjoying that by yourself, all right? Then what happens is that in this process, you will be breaking your own heart in like about, say, 10 days. Okay, accuracy of this, oh my God. Anyway, what I'm trying to say here is that the time frame could vary, but when the guy is not as invested, they will not reciprocate the same amount of efforts that you put into in that whatever situationship that you are in right now. He will not probably reply to you within 10 minutes of you messaging him. He will not probably call you every single day. He will start being too like laid back about you because he already has you, and he does not really see you as a girl who he wants to invest a lot of time in to build a future with. Okay, unfortunately, that's the case. They just see you as this person, this fun girl, who's nice, who they vibe with, and who they can be casual with. Okay, there's no harm in being casual also. Let me just clear this part out as well. I do not mean to say that being casual with a person is a bad thing, or being in a relationship should be your only goal. You have to decide for yourself, are you looking for a casual thing? Are you looking for a serious relationship? Okay, and you know what happens generally is also that it depends from people to people, right? Like, for what happens is that you know in your head that you are looking for a relationship, but you obviously don't really come across such kind of guys that match your requirements every now and then. So once you get that guy, you start looking at him in a different perspective. But when you see other men who are nice and who you vibe with, you probably might want to just keep it casual with them, all right? But ऐसा कभी कभी ये भी हो जाता है दैट यू ऑल्सो फॉल एंड अप फॉलिंग फॉर द कैजुअल गाय. दैट इज द फक अप, ओके? दैट इज व्हाट हर्ट्स द मोस्ट, बिकॉज यू आर लाइक, ब्रो, आई डिडंट इवन लाइक हिम इन द बिगिनिंग. आई वाज जस्ट बीइंग कैजुअल एंड लुक एट मी नाउ, आई एम क्राइंग फॉर दिस ड्यूड, यू नो? या, अनफॉर्चुनेटली, आई मीन, इट्स द सैड ट्रूथ फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस. इन ऑर्डर टू सेव योर सेल्फ फ्रॉम अ डिजास्ट्रस हार्ट ब्रेक, सो दैट यू डू नॉट एंड अप हेटिंग मैन, और यू डू नॉट एंड अप कैंसलिंग मैन बिकॉज, ओ, एवरी गाय दैट आई मीट जस्ट ओनली वॉन्ट्स टू हुक अप विद मी एंड एवरीथिंग. इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोटेक्ट योर self, and in order to like just have a nice healthy whatever relationship, or casual thing, or whatever that you want, it's important that you be clear with your communication with the other person. Okay, that might not happen in the beginning. Obviously, take your time to understand what you really want out of this person. Then you see, okay, अब इज द टाइम दैट आई एक्चुअली आस्क हिम डायरेक्टली, एंड देर इज एब्सोल्युटली नथिंग टू फियर or worry about, okay, this guy will go if I ask him something, I'll make things awkward. It's fine, make things awkward. It's all right. It's for your own mental health and your own sanity that you ask him what is going on and what does he want. It's very normal. So just put it out there, you know. So, okay, so what is it that you're looking for exactly? You know, we've been talking for a while and I really like you, but I really want to know, where are you on, you know, where do I stand in this, and are we on the same page, etc., etc. So you can frame it nicer and you can just put it out there saying that I want this. So if you want casual, you can be like, okay, I'm not looking for a relationship, but you know, we really vibe and let's just keep it chill, you know, or something. I don't know. But or if you want a relationship, you can also be like, okay, you know, we've been talking for a while and I've been in this whole zone where I really want a partner for myself, and I think you're really nice and you're really sweet and I would want to explore this. Do not say that I want a relationship with you. The guy will get scared, because anybody would get scared in the beginning if you directly put like, I want a relationship. You can't say that. You have to also, for yourself, figure it out, take time, meet the person a few times before you actually call it a relationship. Okay, that is called the dating phase. You know, the actual dating phase should last about, I think, 2 months at least, where you meet at least, you know, 10-12 times. You actually spend a lot of time before you get into a relationship with that person. Also, now, when to understand if you're in a casual relationship, I'll give you a few symptoms, few hacks to know if you are in a casual relationship or a situationship with a person, and if you're confused, okay, right now, if you don't understand where this is heading and if you're like really worked up about this guy, if that guy is on your mind all the time and you're not understanding what is happening, listen to me now very carefully, okay? If your answer to any of whatever I'm going to be saying further is yes, say 3 out of 5 is yes, then you are in a casual relationship, okay? Like, you are in a situationship. So then you have to take it further like that. Okay, number one, if it's been a very short period of time, you've been attached and you're already crying for the guy because he's not replying to your messages, and if you're already worried, why is he not responding to my messages, or why is he not calling me? We used to talk a lot in the beginning, etc., etc., etc. If that is the vibe right now that you are in, it's a situationship. He's not into you in a very serious thingy. Probably, maybe he's busy, maybe there's a lot of work, but even if there's work, the person will probably reply to you saying that, you know, okay, I'm busy, I will get back to you in a couple of days or something like that. But if the person is not even you know, making that effort, then he's not taking you as seriously. You obviously vibe, so whenever you talk, you have that vibe, but that's about it. He does not want to stretch it too much, okay? I'm sorry. Yeah. Number 2. If you've been stalking him constantly because he hasn't replied to your messages or your texts, or if you're checking if he's online, why is he online, why is he not talking to me, why is he, you know, not doing that, oh, he's read my message, oh, there's a blue tick, oh, he's done that, oh, he's done. Again, I've checked and confirmed this with a lot of guys who are already in a relationship and who've been through the whole casual dating zone. And now they're in a relationship. I checked with them and they said that when they found the girl for them, they wanted to talk to them every single day and they wanted to, like, you know, be there for that girl, and they actually would put in an effort every day to talk to that person. So if that person is, if your guy is not putting in that kind of effort, if he's keeping you very confused and if he's not around with you and if he's not, like, whatever, you guys are not talking for days, no matter what he said, he's not your guy. Damn. Oh. Okay, number 3 is, if you haven't really spent a lot of time together, if you've only been talking, you know, if you've only been texting, if the guy is not taking an initiative to call you or to video call you or to, like, you know, just call you, then again, it could be a casual thing, because just texting does not qualify as a person being interested in you. If they are interested in you, they will take it further. They will want to talk to you. They will want to get to know you, because texting is quite formal. Like, you cannot really say a lot of things in a text. But when it comes to, like, talking, you actually get to know a person better because you're talking and you want to know more. And, you know, the call can actually go on for hours, right, in the beginning. But if there is no conversation happening on the phone, then it's just a casual thingy. How to know if a guy really wants a relationship with you? Number 1, I think men, when they finally made their mind that, okay, you know, I'm in this phase right now that I want a relationship, I'm looking for a partner, and, you know, whatever, you know, the hookup phase is behind me, I really am looking for somebody. So I think men are clear about that in the beginning itself, because they are like, okay, bro, abhi to bas ho gaya. They will also not invest their lot of time and energy on just people who are looking for casuals, okay? Maybe they will, maybe they won't, but mostly they don't. So they are also very clear in the beginning that, you know, we are looking for something more serious, and that does not mean that this will end up in something. We will see where it goes. But that is important that a guy tells you that, yes, I am looking for a relationship. So that is your cue that, okay, this guy looks like somebody who actually probably wants to get into something more serious, right? But that does not mean that you start fantasizing about this guy again in your head and, like, you know, start creating stories and everything, because you will only break your heart if this doesn't go well, okay? So I think situationships are getting very normal these days. They're getting glorified, and people are getting more and more depressed because, you know, it's so easy to, like, ghost somebody and not take responsibility of how you made them feel, and, you know, what the other person is feeling and what just happened between you guys in, like, a matter of, like, say, a month. You guys were talking, one of them got attached, the other one said, oh, I didn't even mean it that way, and then the other person had to, like, you know, whatever, carry all of that weight and, you know, deal with all of the emotions by themselves. So I feel like dating is really difficult in the sense that sometimes there's a lot of confusion, but I think all of that confusion can be cleared if your communication, if you are straightforward with your communication with the other person. Okay, so now I'm gonna give you all a mantra, okay, which is what I follow, and it has helped me, and it really works all the time, okay, is to make sure that your thoughts, your words, and your actions match. When you're talking about something or when you want something, if you want something, you will think about that. Okay, TK, now I'm ready to get into a relationship, all right? So those are your thoughts. Okay, then when you talk to somebody, when you meet a guy, you tell him that, okay, you know what, I am looking for a relationship, so we'll see where this goes. That's your words, okay? Now your actions are something that has to follow up with your thoughts, words. I can say that, okay, yeah, even I'm looking for a relationship, but it could very quickly stumble into a physical thing, because then you get relaxed about the whole fact that, okay, even he's looking for something serious. So probably getting into bed with this guy should not be a problem because we're both looking for the same thing. But I think you should hold on to the sex part of it. You should hold on to the whole physical part of it, because just get to know the person more. Get to know his intentions. See if he really wants to, you know, be with you. If you are sure that, you know, TK, if you sleep with this guy and it doesn't end well, if कल को उठ के वो आपको कुछ एक एग्जिट स्ट्रैटेजी दे देगा कि हाँ, अच्छा, मुझसे तो नहीं होगा, आई मीन आई एम स्टिल नॉट ओवर माई एक्स, ओ आई डोंट थिंक आई एम रेडी फॉर अ रिलेशनशिप वगैरह वगैरह, आफ्टर यू स्लेप्ट विद द गाय, एंड इफ यू आर श्योर दैट इट विल नॉट हर्ट यू, देन यू कैन टेक द डिसीजन ऑफ स्लीपिंग विद द गाय, ओके? बट इफ यू नो फॉर अ फैक्ट दैट इट विल हर्ट यू एंड यू विल एंड अप डिप्रेस्ड बिकॉज यू विल बी लाइक, ओ पर मैंने तो उसको ये भी कर दिया, आई डिड दैट ऑल्सो फॉर हिम एंड आई डिड दिस ऑल्सो फॉर हिम एंड नाउ ही इज गिविंग मी ऑल ऑफ दीज रीजंस दैट आई कांट बी इन अ रिलेशनशिप विद यू, दैट मीन्स योर थॉट्स, वर्ड्स एंड एक्शंस डिड नॉट मैच, यू डिडंट हैव टू स्लीप विद हिम, यू टोल्ड हिम दैट यू वांटेड अ रिलेशनशिप, सो एक्ट लाइक इट. जस्ट बी लाइक, ओके, लेट्स गो आउट फॉर अ कपल ऑफ डेट्स, लेट्स गो आउट फॉर अ कपल ऑफ मंथ्स, एंड देन वी नो विल जस्ट टेक इट आगे वहां से. वाई डू हैव टू लाइक बी इन अ हरी टू लाइक स्लीप विद अ पर्सन, बिकॉज यू नो फॉर अ फैक्ट दैट इफ यू वांट अ रिलेशनशिप विद हिम, ही इज गोना बी देयर विद यू फॉर अ लाइफ टाइम, राइट? सो होल्ड ऑन टू द सेक्स फॉर अ वाइल, कीप द सेक्स आउट ऑफ इट, लाइक गेट टू नो द पर्सन मोर. एंड आई डू नॉट विश टू साउंड ओल्ड स्कूल अगेन. आई नो अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल आर गोना मैसेज मी सेइंग दैट, ओ बट यू मीन दैट फर्स्ट टाइम इफ यू हैव सेक्स देन यू नो पीपल विल नॉट लाइक यू और लाइक दे विल लीव यू. आई एम जस्ट सेइंग दैट दैट इज नॉट द केस 100% ऑफ द टाइम. पीपल हु आर मैच्योर, इफ यू आर मीटिंग अ गाय हु इज लाइक सो मैच्योर एंड हु इज लाइक इवॉल्व्ड, प्रोबेबली फॉर हिम सेक्स माइट नॉट बी अ डील ब्रेकर, ओके? बट इफ यू आर अ यंग गर्ल, इफ यू आर अ टीनेजर, वेयर इवन द गाय इज अ टीनेजर, ही इज नॉट इवॉल्व्ड, ही इज नॉट एज मैच्योर, ओके? सो फॉर हिम वंस द सेक्स हैपेंस, इट कैन गेट अ लिटिल यू नो ईजी फॉर हिम एंड देन ही विल बी लाइक, ओके, यू नो व्हाट, विल सी, विल थिंक अबाउट इट और व्हाटएवर व्हाटएवर. सो जस्ट गेट to know the person, get to know his intentions, see how serious he is to be with you, see how, you know, comfortable he makes you, and then you can get into a physical relationship. Who's denying you, dude? Like, go for it, like, it's your life, like, have fun, of course, but just not at the cost of your own mental health. Basically, I'm gonna narrow it down to just a few points so that it's easier for you guys to remember. If you want to be in a casual relationship or if you want to be in a long-term relationship, firstly, prepare yourself mentally here. Like, you decide what do you want from this guy, okay? Once you've made up your mind, I know it's very difficult. Sometimes we get attached and, you know, it's not in your hands and you actually do fall for the sweet words and then you end up making scenarios. But keep reminding yourself that this is not the guy for you, and you've already spoken to him about being casual and he also wants to be casual with you. So you cannot expect him to love you now, okay? That will not magically happen. Do not expect that and break your own heart. Got it? So number one, communicate with the person, ask him what he wants, you tell him what he wants, and there is nothing to be shy about. This guy is not gonna get mad. If he gets mad, that's not the person for you anyway. Okay, but communicate, tell him what you want, be open about you yourself, okay, and then let him, like, then understand what he wants. And if he's not clearly communicating what he wants, keep asking him. Kuch farak nahi padta, usko poochte ho. Jab tak wo seedha seedha nahi bol dega ki haan mujhe relationship nahi chahiye ya mujhe relationship chahiye. These should be the words. I want to be in a relationship, or I am looking for a serious relationship, or I am only looking for a hookup. These should be the words, clear, black and white, not gray. That should not give you mixed signals like, oh, but he said this, matlab uska ye ho sakta. You don't have to connect the dots anyway. It has to be crisp, it has to be clear, written in your face. And then after that, agar aapke muh pe usne likh diya hai ki nahi, I don't want a relationship, and you still after this guy, then to bro, it's your fault, okay? Then you can't blame anybody. But ask him. I'm telling you, it's your right. Ask him. Sharmao mat, okay? Pooch lo yaar, isme koi sharam wali baat nahi hai. Okay, number one, communication. Clear, crisp communication. Number two, follow your own thoughts, words, actions. Make sure that whatever has been the communication with you guys, like whatever you guys have decided on, you have to follow it up. You cannot change, because once you change, agar aapne bol diya ki casual hai aur uske baad then you start liking him, then you start, like, you know, pushing yourself on him, wo galat ho jayega. You will break your own heart. Okay, so in order to save yourself a heartbreak, it's always good to follow your own thoughts, words and actions. Make sure everything is in sync so that things can happen smoothly for you. Okay, and yeah, that is it for now, I think. So yeah, I hope this video made a little bit of sense. If it did, let me know in the comment section below, and what more videos would you like to see in terms of dating and relationships, because I would love to share my gyan with y'all. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. If it did, do not forget to give it a big thumbs up and also share it with a friend, because I know for a fact there is a girl in your friend circle who is in a situationship right now, and she's screaming for this video, and you will save her a heartbreak with this video. So share it with her, and don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, and also don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. And that is it for now. I will see you all really soon. Bye.